Tampa at beautiful Raymond James Stadium near Florida's Gulf Coast. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Baltimore Ravens and our home team. They'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. On first down, Purdy. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down.
Oh, boy, partner, did that just happen? I've got my hand over my eyes right now because, like him, it's going to haunt my dreams, too. He was wide open. How did he overthrow him there?
Defensively, just very lucky. You know that they got away with one there. Back to throw now on second and 10. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Good work after the catch, gets him 15 and a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Here we go. Here we go. Five.
To throw on second down. Purdy is complete to Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 12 yards there and a first down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 47. They run on first down, but it only produces a gain of 2. It's second down now. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Three down. Hey, check.
There you go.
Looking to throw on second down. Purdy, he's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 31-yard line.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone?
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. To throw again, Purdy. And he comes back with one complete. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens' 20-yard line.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion.
Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. First and 10 right at the 20. From the gun, Purdy. His throw caught at about the 5. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Well, he did everything but get him in the end zone there, but now they're set up. Golden opportunity, strong opening drive, and they're knocking on the door.
And the way that they did it, now look where they are on the field, all right? This is naturally set up for a running play, isn't it? But with his ability...
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Well, if you're going to throw the ball on first and goal from the 2, the worst thing that should result is an incompletion for you offensively. But, Brandon, this is a different type of football. Back in my day, first and goal from the 2, a lot of big people with big neck rolls, they were on the field trying to ram it into the end zone.
To throw on second down, Purdy. This will be caught at about the 5. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's 3rd and goal.
Well, I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's 3 catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. 3 catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone setter. They lost 2, and it brings up 4th. Well, you throw it this close to the goal line, usually you're thinking touchdown. Here they actually complete it but lose yardage.
When you're this close to the goal line, you have to anticipate that maybe you're going to see a defense that you can make a case that there's 11 in the box. There's just no room. So I'm with you. You got to find a way to push things downfield a little bit. Any type of space is better than what we just saw there. And that end result, not one that's satisfactory to them.
Well, after marching down the field, only getting 3 there, kind of feels like a win for the defense.
And it does. They'll go to the sideline feeling a lot better that they didn't give up a touchdown after the march against them. But if I were the offense, I wouldn't hang my head over that one. That's a good drive, and 3 points were put on the board.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Ravens here going to get the football back on offense, but let's look big picture at what's going on right now. They lead the AFC North by 2 games, and I know we're only 6 weeks in, but that's a nice little cushion.
It's an excellent cushion because you had to consider going into the season and you had to figure Pittsburgh would be right there neck and neck with them. Baltimore, you knew, would be a contender. And, of course, Cleveland was everyone's darling in the preseason. So to be 2 games clear at this point of the season, that's big for them. The best part, they can actually extend the lead. They go to Seattle, and they can play with just about anyone, have an open week, home to the Patriots on a Sunday night game, and then a rematch with the Bengals. You have to figure at the least they win 1 of those 3, maybe even 2.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. Here we go on 2nd and 12. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at 3rd down.
You got him! Ha ha, you got him!
An extra cornerback now in the game for the Chargers here on 3rd. They'll look to throw here. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
The Ravens send their punter out now as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the 5. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line. Chargers offense getting the football back here. CD, let's return to that week 6 game against the Steelers. Now, yes, they were at home, but really, as Al Michaels said during the broadcast, it was about 80% Steeler fans, a lot of terrible towels in the stadium. But if you look at this team right now at 2-4, injured offensive line, what do we make of them?
They've got to figure out another way to fashion offense, and they're hoping with the return of Melvin Gordon, they can become two-dimensional again, that he can actually run the football and take some of the pressure off of the offensive line and Phillip Rivers throwing it, as well as circling out of the backfield and catching it himself. That has to happen soon, because otherwise, they're going to be out of this race. The Chargers are on the road now against 2 top 10 defenses at Tennessee, then at Chicago.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Purdy throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route, the drag, and being able to run away from defenders. Hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. Taken from just outside the 30. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. 3 and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Yeah, let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit.
Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. 2nd and 4. He finds his man, Johnson. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Here we go, set, 8, read. Ready.
They'll look to throw now on first down. This one complete, Ingram. At the 50, right at midfield.
That was well defended, and while it was a completion, it resulted in a loss of yardage. It's really, really hard for a running back to think to himself, I probably should have just dropped it and saved the yardage. It goes against the entire training that he's had his whole career.
On 2nd down, there's the option going left. Stepping up, he'll try and run. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. He'll get 2 on the keeper, but it becomes now a 3rd down. Come on, now this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Three nothing after 1 on EA Sports. Raven football here as we begin quarter number 2. They've got it 3rd and 10 here to start things out.
15, Ronnie.
15,
Ronnie.
Just like that. Get it. They'll drop to throw. He may try and run for this. And he will avoid the contact as he slides to a stop. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 36.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
70, Indy. It's just me and you. It's just me and you. Let's go.
On 2nd down, Ingram. A 1-yard gain there following the 3-yard pickup on 1st down.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the Trash Man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7.
He'll look to throw. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And that will tie us at 3-3. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Field goals, all we've had so far. 3-3 now as the kick is away. This is taken at the 3. Oh, he breaks another. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. Well, we got a second. Let's look ahead to Week 7 and what's on the slate. Things start out Thursday night. Kansas City at Denver, divisional battle.
Suddenly an interesting game. Kansas City having lost their last two, and Denver now playing defense as we expected. But how about the NFL 100 game of the week? Oakland at Green Bay, a rematch of Super Bowl II.
Also have New Orleans at Chicago and Philly visiting Dallas on Sunday night.
That is a huge one in the NFC East.
Yeah, both teams 3-3. The winner will have the lead in that division. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. But big plays? Let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Operating from the gun, Purdy. This will be caught inside the 10. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
The beauty of route running is it doesn't matter what position, everyone's doing the same thing. In this case, tight end selling the vertical route. Get the defensive back on his heels, break off for the corner. With good timing, you get a completion, as we just saw there.
Looking to throw, Purdy. And he's got it. He'll get only 2 there, and it's second and goal.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal.
Four down.
Off play action. Purdy. And touchdown, Chargers. And maybe the defense caught a little by surprise there that he took off and got in.
Yeah, I would think so, because if you're analyzing it from that side of the ball, you're thinking running back, fullback. Takes you a while before you get to the quarterback.
Now for the point after. And it is up. And it's good. That'll make our score 10-3 now. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Nice job there defensively. A great time to dial up a blitz.
And give him credit under center instead of throwing it away. Actually, a pretty good job of getting past the line of scrimmage, not losing yardage. They'll go option to the short side. And no pitch there and no chance either as he's brought down behind the line of scrimmage.
I don't think there's any doubt that if it's me, I'd be really cautious about continuing to call this play because you got to know, defenders, if they get a free shot at the QB, they want to take it, and they want to take it big.
And they got it there on the option play for a loss. They'll set up to throw. He gets this one to Johnson. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. It'll be a gain of eight, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And that'll hit at the five and go into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Okay, now I want to revisit what we were doing earlier, contender versus pretender. We did the AFC, let's rock the NFC here. Starting with the New York Giants.
Pretender, but much improved.
Okay, NFC North, how about the Vikings?
Contender, no doubt about it.
Carolina in the South, what do you think there?
Contender and ascending.
Okay, the quarterback play has become a good thing for them. Finally, out West, how about the Arizona Cardinals?
Pretender. The division's just way too tough. There are three teams better than them.
Come on, set.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Single. And watch the ball.
From the gun, Purdy. Looking downfield for Jones, and that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield, but that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. They'll run it now out of the gun. Takes this one across the 35 to the 36, a gain of about four. The Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third. Operating from the gun, Purdy. Down. The Ravens able to get to him. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On is the Chargers punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. Pulled in at the 24. And 9 yards there on the return following a punt of 47. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Ravens offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. And it's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
Sliding out of the pocket. He'll try and run it. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
First down now, but that clock rolling. He'll set up a throw. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. 25 yards that time.
Let's go, baby. Let's go.
I know you're trying not to scoreboard watch, but you only got 3 points. You're kind of hoping that that type of play there gives you some positive momentum going into the half.
Yeah, I need to do something to get more than that three number that they have on the scoreboard right now. So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, and now we're going to New York, right? That's command central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision because they do have the final call now.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Looking to throw. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And down to the 16-yard line. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
First red zone chance now for the Ravens. They come up first and 10 at the 16. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Took nearly the entire first half, but a first red zone opportunity for him here. They come up first and 10 at the 16. They'll roll him out right. He'll run it, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
Here we go! Ken Lobo. I got him.
Now back to throw. He's got it to Ingram, complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. From 10 yards out, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game.
I don't think it's any state secret to know what they were saying before the start of this drive. Let's go and punch one in the end zone and go into the halftime feeling a heck of a lot better about ourselves. Let's go get this done.
Yeah, tie things up, and then you got a brand new ball game. Point after, right down the middle. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. All level now at 10 apiece as the kick's away. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Chargers getting set to go. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. Set second and two. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. On third and two, Purdy. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Throwing on first down, Purdy. Stepping up, he'll try and run. And he slides to avoid the hill. And with 1 second left, they get the timeout. And they'll have a chance to kick the field goal before intermission. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. Made his first, this now from 42 yards out. And his kick is right there. It's good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. This one taken from the 7. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Here's the option going left on second down. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it, but it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be 3rd down.
And that's when it's fun to play defense, when you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football, and spill the play. That's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
Back to throw here. He can run for it, and he will. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A good decision in the end. The pull it and run gets him 9 yards at a first.
Normally we're talking about a quarterback duel where they're matching each other pass for pass. How about the footwork in this one? Both of these guys running the ball well.
Yeah, they've mixed in the run game. You're exactly right. Now, both coaches might not like how much their quarterbacks have taken off, but another example right there of just good mobility. Now this one complete downfield on the left side. A good pickup there, 21 yards. And on this challenge, the refs have to take a peek and see whether or not the receiver was able to dot the I with both feet.
While making sure that he possesses the football all the way through the catch.
Ready, ready. 60 or. We own it. Get it.
This will be caught just inside the 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
I think a lot of people ask the same question all the time. Why do we see so many slants in the red zone? Well, the windows are tighter. Everything's more condensed. It has to be quicker. And you've got to deliver the ball on time. Your biggest worry? Ball gets tipped in the air. Because if that happens, then it's fair game for the defense.
And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to 1.
They'll run here with Ingram. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
They come out here in the eye. Second and goal from the 1. And again, it's Ingram. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up 3rd down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
They'll look to throw. Rolling to his right. Touchdown, Ravens! They were looking to pass the ball there, but they forgot to account for the man with the football.
Yeah, I can hear people right now saying, well, why don't you have a spy in your defense, someone who will dance with him and go where he goes? Well, oftentimes, if you utilize a spy, you've taken away someone in coverage as well. And oftentimes, the spy, not as athletic as the guy he's trying to keep up with, so he gets defeated anyway.
And he turns 3rd and goal into a touchdown. Extra point right down the middle. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Now a look at the Chargers offense. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know in the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start. Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
They'll run it now out of the gun. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a 3rd and about 4 for a first.
He wasn't ready.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
On the ready. And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the gun, Purdy. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Now that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football. Led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
On is the Chargers punter now, as he'll come on to kick this one away. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. This is fielded at the 27. They'll call it a punt of 44 yards. The return was for 7. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
The drive will start with an option going left. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, 2nd and 2.
Oh man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it. And while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way.
They get 14 on that one. That's good for a Baltimore first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So the 14 yards actually takes them from 143 to the other for 1st and 10. Now this time he'll look to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. 36 yards on the play.
That's a real nice job right there, working the middle of the field, working against those safeties. And you know, partner, if you get your hips turned the wrong way, big plays can result.
And a big play resulted right there. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's 1st and goal just outside the 5. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be 2nd down.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on 2nd and goal. Here's a 2nd and 7. To the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete.
Now we got 3rd and goal coming up, and couldn't you imagine being in that huddle, partner? You know they're looking at each other saying, we can't come away with just 3 points after this drive.
Yeah, they've covered a lot of ground. They want more than that 3.
Go. 260 out, go.
Everyone go. Head up.
They're going to look to throw. And it's caught. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. A terrific job there to keep him out of the end zone. And now it'll be 4th and goal. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. And his kick here is good. And that will finish off this 3rd quarter of play. Back now in Tampa, where the 4th quarter will begin with a kickoff following the score on the final play of the 3rd quarter. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken at the 3. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Throwing to start the drive, Purdy. And he's got his man on the out route. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
On 1st and 10, Purdy. And down he goes. goes. A coverage sack. Took too long to get rid of it.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Back to throw. Purdy. He completes it to Jones. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
On third down, Purdy. It's caught, Jones. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 23 yards on the play. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side before lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
Second and 14. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
I got it.
From the gun on third down, Purdy. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7, but first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. Yikes, a 4-yard loss really sets them back now for second down.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get them in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
This is caught. And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. Only able to pick up 2, and that leads us to third and goal.
I think we should put a stopwatch on that one. You talk about having all day to throw the football, able to scan the field, find someone open after a long time. Big time credit to the offensive line for protection. That's what we used to call throwing out of the rocking chair.
They'll try to run this one in. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
I know this is your spot, partner, so forgive me for jumping in, but there's no decision right here. They have to go for it in this situation. They're down on the scoreboard. How many other opportunities are you going to get?
Yeah, I'm with you. Fourth quarter, like you said, down on the scoreboard. And remember here, a field goal virtually does them no good. And he's not going to get in. They stop him at the 1. They stop him on 4th and goal at the 3. And the Ravens come up big down at their own goal line. They'll start by running the option to the right. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
On the draw, this is Ingram. And he gets it up to the 10-yard line here. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. A tight game like this, such a tough spot for the offense to be in, even though they have the lead, Charles, back up so close to their goal line, they got to protect the football.
And that's when you have to take care of your team with play calling as well. Not a lot of misdirection, not a lot of counters, not a lot of plays where you have extra ball handling. Get it right to the hands of your running back, tell him to take care of the ball, and try and move forward.
A little bit of space there for the first down run, as that's going to get him about 5 yards. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4 yard pickup leaves him with third and one. They'll try to run for the first with Ingram. And he is going to have the first down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd. A pickup of 5 that time and a first down. Hasn't been his best afternoon on the ground, far from it, but a critical third down conversion.
His afternoon just got better. All right, you're exactly right. Hasn't been his best in terms of yardage, but that run there, that's the one your teammates look to you and go, okay, that's what we want from you. That's what we need. Now they have a chance to keep moving forward and a chance to win the game.
A run there on first down going nowhere as he stopped right at the 25. No gain on the play there. Second down. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them. Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something, and they did in this one. So the final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory. And you look back over the score sheet, interesting. A very clean game, no turnovers by either side.
An absolute rarity when we watch games now because defenses have put such an emphasis on taking the ball away. Well, what we saw here was offenses spending their time saying, look, you know they're coming for it. Ball security is paramount. So they worked on that, not just the week of practice, but I'm sure all during training camp. Make sure when you have it, tuck it away because danger lurks everywhere you turn.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long from Tampa.